Hi, welcome to Mica Tutorials. I am Mica Motwani. In previous tutorial, we have seen how we can make use of Bean Factory to instantiate a bean. Now, in this tutorial, we are going to see how we can make use of application context to instantiate a bean. Basically, application context is just an extension to Bean Factory, so it has all the functionalities provided by the Bean Factory, plus it has some extra functionalities like event notification, aspect-oriented programming, etc. Those functionalities will be discussed in subsequent tutorials. Now, in this tutorial, we will simply see how we can make use of application context to instantiate a bean rather than using the Bean Factory. So, we are going to simply comment this code and then we will write the code for instantiating the bean using application context. We have this bean employee for which we had two properties, ID and name, and then we had given the corresponding getter setters and two string method. And this is our XML file where we have given the configuration for the properties of the employee class. Now let's move back to the test class. Now here we need to instantiate application context, which is again an interface, and there are different implementations provided for this interface. We are going to use one of them, and which is class path XML application context. So here we will give class path XML application context. And in this, we can directly pass the name of the configuration file. So here we will give beans.xml. So here we need not to create the resource instance and then to pass that as a parameter, but instead directly we can pass the name of the configuration file, and then we can make use of getBean method to get the bean. And here we are going to make use of this overloaded method. So the name of the ID of the bean we have given is emp, and then second thing that we can give is the class of the bean. So here we will give employee. Now this is going to return a bean, so we can give a reference variable here. So we can give here bean, and then we can print the details here. So we can typecast this in employee, and then we can give bean here. Okay, so now our code is ready for execution. So let's execute it and check the output. So now here we have the object with the values which we have specified in the bean.xml. So ID is 101 and name is Ajay. So this is how we can make use of application context to instantiate a bean. So far we have seen the injection, dependency injection using the setters. Now, in next tutorial, we will see how we can inject the dependencies using constructors rather than the setters. So, thank you for watching this tutorial.